This is ZWO ASI120MM Mini, a mono guiding camera. I've been guiding with this camera for more than a year now, and I thought I would give you my thoughts about it just in case you are wondering if you should buy this or not. Although this is a planetary camera as well, I have been primarily using it for guiding with my SV Boney Mini Guide Scope. That is a perfect match for this camera and my setup. I can say that it has proved to be a very capable guide camera with little disadvantages. Let's begin by talking about its specifications. ZWO ASI120MM Mini is a CMOS camera from ZWO, a reputable company which produces many high-end cameras. This camera is commonly used for guiding and planetary work. It has a solid reputation of being an effective guide cam. You would find this camera on many rigs. As always, ZWO produces high quality products and this camera is no exception. It uses a CMOS sensor that is capable of reading out at up to 35 frames per second. CMOS technology allows this camera to have high efficiency and sensitivity and faster readout time when compared to CCD cameras. This means that it's more than capable for faster video recording and high speed photos, which is an absolute must for guiding. The sensor is very tiny, perhaps too tiny for serious deep sky astrophotography, but more than enough for the purpose of guiding. Tiny sensor means that the field of view will be small, but that's not an issue for planetary or guiding work. This camera has a resolution of 1:18:960. This is more than sufficient for guiding purposes. If you are using this for planets, you might not be able to show images taken with this on large screens with such resolution. This CMOS sensor has a quantum efficiency of 80%, which is fantastic. If you don't know what quantum efficiency is, well, it's a number that describes the effectiveness of the camera sensor. It tells you how effective the sensor is in converting photons to electrons. With such high quantum efficiency, you would be able to take shorter exposures and still have a reasonable amount of light. The higher the quantum efficiency, the better. The pixel size of this camera is 3.75 and it has low read noise. It does produce images with good high dynamic range. Because this has a small sensor and therefore small field of view, it's recommended that you use a wide field guide scope that will make sure that you have enough stars to guide with. I would highly recommend SV Boney's guide scope. At the rear, this camera is powered by a modern USB-C interface. It unfortunately uses USB 2.0 Type-C port to connect your camera to your controller. It would have been better if this camera used USB 3.0 for faster data transfer. USB 2.0 is more than adequate for guiding, but it might struggle for faster planetary work. I think USB 3 would have been much better. That said, this is compatible with ASI Air Pro. Many older ZWO's guiding cameras aren't really compatible with ASI Air, so in that regard, it's a plus for this camera. Thankfully, it uses a USB-C port, which makes this future-proof. It also has SD4 port, just in case you want to use this to guide Sky Adventurer 2i or Ioptron. If you are using a proper equatorial mount, I would highly recommend against using SD4 port. Use EQ mode cable instead so that all commands are being via the USB cable rather than slower SD4 cable. What I love most about this camera is that it's very small and light. The body is 1.25 inches in diameter, which makes finding focus very easy as the entire camera can go into a 1.25 inch focuser. In terms of weight, it's just 60 grams. So you don't have to worry too much about balancing the weight of the guide camera. Also, if your mount is already pushing its limits, adding this won't really add much weight. In terms of aesthetics, I love the red color and its shininess. There are no plastic parts in this, so it feels good quality and solid. It comes with an extension tube just in case you need that for focus. So what do I think about this? To be very honest with you, I love this camera. It does a great job in guiding. I have tried it for planetary photography as well, and here's a photo that I recently took with it. I would say that for planetary, there are other better options available. But for guiding, this should work perfectly. And I have no hesitation to recommend this to you. So if you need it for guiding, go for it. If you need it for planetary work, there are better options available. My use of this camera is primarily guiding, so I'm a very happy owner of the ZWO ASI 120mm Mini. If you found this video to be helpful, please subscribe. And if you have any questions, feel free to write down below in the comments.